Yeah, Charlie, you hold it.
Okay, guys, go. French.
Bonne chance.
Bonjour.
Bonne chance pour le combat, champion. Bétaille.
Tonton Bakole.
Bétaille.
Tonton Bakole.
Tonton Bakole.
Tonton Bakole.
Yes. We are.
Dugout News YouTube channel is what you watching, guys. Welcome aboard. We have some good news for you in the world of boxing concerning the August 3rd card that is headlined by Terence Bud Crawford versus Israel Madrimov. But there are some wonderful cards on there. I think Martin Bakole and Jared Anderson is one of the cards we should look out for even before the main card of Terence Crawford and Israel Madrimov. Now, Martin Bakole has said that as soon as he opens up, he doesn't think that Gerald Anderson will stand up. Now, Martin Bakole believes the key to victory over Gerald Anderson lies in forcing him back. The heavyweights fight on Saturday at the BMO Stadium in Los Angeles. And this will be on the undercard of Israel Madrimov and Terence Crawford. If Anderson, 24, is considered the future of the heavyweight division, then the Congolese Bakole represents even more so than a challenge to Anderson than Charles Martin ever did. I think this is Gerald Anderson's biggest challenge ever. Now, the 32-year-old Bakole is perhaps the division's most avoided fighter, the bogeyman of the division, and largely because across the course of 21 fights, he has lost only once to Michael Hunter in 2018 when he suffered an injured right shoulder. Anderson, who has won all 17 of his fights as a professional, is continuing to physically and psychologically mature, and he has also spoken about the intense pressure he feels under to succeed. But Bakole believes he has identified a greater and a simpler weakness that he can exploit. As soon as I start landing and pushing him back, I don't think he will fight on the back foot, he told Boxing Scene. So as soon as I open up and start throwing or start fighting, I don't think he will stand up. I was watching his style. The opponents never give him a hard time, but that will never happen with Martin Bakole. That's why I was laughing after watching that. To be honest, he never fights someone who fights back. The opponent was not punching back. That is what makes me laugh. That means that they choose an easy opponent for him. It proves that maybe it's because that happens to every young prospect, heavyweight or boxer. But I don't think they should give him some good opponents. You'll be in big trouble, because I am 100% more than all the opponents that he fights. So it's going to be a surprise. Someone who is attacking him, giving him a hard time, no time to rest, I think he will give up. Maybe his corner will throw in the towel. Nothing impressed me, because he was going to impress me if there was someone who was fighting back, giving him a hard time, push him to the wall or push him on the back foot. But since I didn't see that, nothing about watching him impressed me. The pressure to which Anderson refers owes so much to America's desire to have another leading heavyweight. Deontay Wilder's decline may even have increased that pressure, which perhaps is ironic given how limited he appeared when he encountered opponents capable of forcing him backwards. I can't let anybody control me in the ring, never, Bakole continued. Never let someone control me, so that would be a big problem. I never saw Anderson get a punch. I just only watched one fight. I never saw him get a beautiful left hook or a beautiful body punch or uppercut and survive. I never saw something like that. Maybe I will see it in the ring. I don't know if he will survive or he will continue. That is Martin Bakole. He also said that he sees fear in Jared Anderson's eyes ahead of their fight. And you see, Bakole says that he saw fear in Jared Anderson's eyes during their face-off at the Grand Arrivals in Los Angeles ahead of their heavyweight fight this Saturday at the BMO Stadium. Bakole, we all know that he's at 20 fights, 1 loss, 15 KOs, and he says that he saw the fear in the 24-year-old Anderson's eyes, knowing he can't take it. The 6'6 Bakole predicts an early knockout in the 5th round against Anderson, and he's looking forward to it. Martin Bakole says if he doesn't knock Anderson out, he will punish him and beat him in their fight on the Zen pay-per-view. Many fans will watch this fight, and it will be a great way for Bakole to introduce himself to the U.S. public. He's been out there saying that many of the British fighters avoid him. Does he feel the same against Americans? He's facing an American in Jarrell Anderson, huge prospect, but showed weaknesses in his fight against Charles Martin, a former heavyweight champion. He was dethroned by Anthony Joshua a couple of years back. And you see, Jarrell Anderson did a good job of disguising his fear by laughing and clowning when he was on stage with Bakole on Tuesday. It looked like Anderson was acting, trying to cover up that worry. I actually was also feeling the same, because he was a little bit unstable, laughing, doing all the kind of things. I think he's at he's going to be getting his the hugest test he will ever get in the boogeyman of the division, Martin Bakole. We had the boogeyman in Filip Hogovic. He was beaten by Daniel Dubois in a good performance by Daniel Dubois. Now, Martin Bakole is the other guy that has been calling out all top heavyweights for some years now. And he was yet to get in the ring with someone like Jarrell Anderson, that is highly ranked and also taunted as a huge prospect. At one time, the likes of Tyson Fury coming out to say that he's the future of the heavyweight division. And we'll wait and see. But while he tries to overcome this challenge, it will be guns blazing on that day, because this Saturday, this is also a huge one in the heavyweight division. That is Jarrell Big Baby Mira and Andy Ruiz Jr. That will also be on the undercard, or the card, main card of Terence Crawford versus Israel Madrimov. What do you think of Martin Bakole saying that this is fear, or he saw fear in Jarrell Anderson's eyes, and also saying that Jarrell Anderson has never seen what he's going to bring to the table, that Jarrell Anderson has never faced a guy that fights fire with fire, and this is what he will be getting? And he predicts a 5th round knockout or his corner stopping the fight. What do you think of all that? Place your comment in the comment section below. I sign out. Peace.
Yeah, Charlie, you hold it. Okay, guys, go. French.
Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Bonjour. Pour le combat champion.
Yes, we are here. We just finished training, me and Billy. We wish you luck, all the team. We are behind you. Let's go.